Kakadosh Boketov. I was asked a very interesting question, so I just wanted to answer as following. Siman Kuf Kaftet in Shulchan Aruch Eben Ezer Sif Yotchet is speaking about when we are writing Shemot Begitim. Shemot Begitim means when you're going to write a name in the get, one of the most important concepts in writing a name is getting the name properly, because a lot of the other parts, even if there's going to be a little mistake, sometimes as long as it's not part of the main part of the get, it's still going to be kosher. However, though, the name is one of the most focused on, and that's why Siman Kuf Kaftet, there's even an entire sefer, right, of the Bet Shemuel and others, just on this Siman, because it's so important, because of the names. Maran brings down in Sif Yotchet, Mi Shenishtana Shemo Mechamat Choli, somebody that's name is changed because of a sickness. Af Al Pi Shekorino Totami B'Shem Arishon, even though they're always going to call him for the first name, Mikomakom Shema Shinui Ikar, the Shema Shinui is going to be the Ikar, Vekotvino To Kodem, and they write it beforehand. Ve'achar kach demitkere ploni Shema Rishon, and then afterwards they write, demitkere is called another name, which means, if for example his name was Yosef, and then they're going to add the name Chaim, so then what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to call him Chaim Yosef, not Yosef Chaim. Chaim Yosef, if it's going to be Moshe Chaim, so it's going to be Chaim Moshe, not Moshe Chaim. The reason why is because this name that you just added on became the Ikar name. And now what takes the precedence is that then you would write down the Mitkiri that he's also called. This was going to be the original name. However, though, what happens in a case where he does not become better? So here there's a Bet Shemuel. The Bash comes and he says that really, Behemet, there's going to be three different cases. But he says as follows. V'im lo nikra bo klal. What happens if he was never called by the name? For example, a woman, or a man, asher nishtana shemo, umet becholyo, he passed away, velo ala lesefer Torah beoto shem. He didn't go up to the Sefer Torah with that name. Velo chatam et atzmo. And he never signed himself with that name. En tzarich lazkir oto Hashem keshemegaresh benot ishto. So therefore, even if it's going to be that his son, chas v'shalom, would divorce, and now we know that when a person gets divorced, they have to write the name of the father. They would not write down the second name of the father. The same is brought down in the Cham, the Chelkat Mechokek. Also, this is one of the first ones in the Siman, which means that after a certain point in Eben Ezer, he stops, and then it's very sporadically where the Chelkat Mechokek will come and write. He also says the exact same halacha. So it's actually brought down in the halacha as follows. If right now a person comes and they are going to be Machzik Ma'amad for 30 days, which means that they became better, and for 30 days they were actually becoming better, and they're actually, you look at them, so then what happens is that they keep the name that was added on. However, though, if right now the person never got better, so therefore, even though it could be that it was after a few months, but at the end of the day, since the person did not become better, the new name did not destroy the decree that the person shouldn't pass away, and therefore what happens is he loses that name. And that you'll find by all of them, even the Rav Avadi Yosef, if you remember, they did add the name Chaim also afterwards. But at the end of the day, once the person passes away, right, and he did not become better, they lose that name. So that is the halacha, that again, two things. Number one, when a person is added a name for a sickness, you always put the adding name as the Ikar, and then the second name, which was his original name, becomes the second name. And number two, it all depends. If he became better, which, and here according to the Bashi Mamash, he has to go up to the Torah with that name, he has to sign by that name. If he became better and it was minimum of 30 days that he became better, so then you would actually add that name. And then even if Chas v'Shalom would pass away afterwards, but at least he would still stick to that name, whether it's going to be in the Matzeva, the Ashkava, and everything else. However, though, if the person did not become better, so therefore he loses that extra name, and he goes back only to the original name.